How often should I pump to increase milk supply? And like always, it depends. So stay tuned to see the options to explore that could benefit your situation. So let's begin. Hi, welcome back. I'm Ginez, lactation consultant, IBCLC, and registered nurse. So be sure to subscribe to the channel for more videos and let me know in the comments what questions you have about pumping, because I'm creating a pumping series. So let's cover the basics. If after birth, you are exclusively pumping, or if breastfeeding is not going well, you should be pumping 8 times in 24 hours. And one of those 8 times should be once overnight. Okay, it's because we want those breastfeeding hormones stimulated all 24 hours. Okay, let's say if you are exclusively breastfeeding and breastfeeding is going well, then there's no need to pump. So your milk supply starts regulating at around between six and 12 weeks. So that is a very important period in your breastfeeding journey. Let's say, for example, you deviated from the recommendation of pumping at least 8 times a day, or maybe you didn't know you needed to pump at least 8 times a day initially to stimulate your milk production. So now you want to know how often you should be pumping. So first we have to get to those 8 milk removals in 24 hours, including once overnight. Okay, so let's say you are pumping, we need to do eight milk removals in 24 hours. Okay, if you're breastfeeding and you want to start pumping because you want to increase production, then you want to pump after breastfeeding. You want to pump after breastfeeding your baby. And you could do this a few times a day for about 10 to 15 minutes. And you want to test it for like 3-5 days to see how it goes. At the beginning, you won't see a lot of milk come out because remember, your baby just breastfed. So whatever amount of milk you get is all bonus milk. So let's say you're pumping, you're exclusively pumping, and you want to know how many times you need to pump to increase milk supply. So again, we want to start with 8 times in 24 hours, including once overnight. And then let's say that you are already doing that, right? Then we want to increase, we want to find your magic number. We want to find that magic number that is how many times you need to have milk removals from your breast in order to produce enough milk for your baby. And you could check my video on baby stomach size, so you know exactly how much your baby should be drinking based on their age. Okay, so that's a good indication on how to know how much to pump or how much you should be producing. Okay, so let's say if you were not pumping 8 times a day, we're gonna start doing that, including once overnight. If you were already pumping 8 times a day, then we're gonna add sessions to that. We could add, you know, 2-3 sessions. You could start with 2 sessions a day. So if you were pumping 8, then we're gonna pump 10 times a day. So this is a process. We need to give your body time to adjust and start producing more milk. I recently made a video on increasing milk supply and the best way to increase milk supply. So be sure to watch that after this video. So the goal is to produce just what baby needs, right? Not an oversupply, not an undersupply. So what you're going to do is you're gonna start at 8 times a day, and then you're gonna find out how much you pump, how much milk you pump, right? And if that is too much for baby, then you could drop 1 session and see how your body does in the next few days. If there's a big dip, then you could add that session back in. If you are doing 8 times a day, but it's still not enough for what baby is consuming, then you want to add sessions to your pumping routine. If you're already doing 8, then you want to, let's say, start doing 10 times in 24 hours, including once overnight. And you want to pump for about 20 minutes. So if you want to find out your storage capacity, what you do is you pump in the middle of the night or your first pumping session in the morning, and that amount is your storage capacity. And that is how much milk your breasts hold at their fullest. So remember, you need to give, if you're adding sessions to your pumping schedule, you need to give it time. You need to give it a few days, 3 to 7 days to see how your body reacts and to see the change. Give these tips a try and let me know in the comments section if they worked for you. What is your magic number? Please let me know in the comments. I want to know. So these are my tips on how often you should pump to increase milk supply. I hope the video was helpful. If it was, give it a like and be sure to subscribe to the channel to join my tribe. So leave your pumping questions in the comments section because I'll continue to make videos to support your pumping routine and your pumping journey. So thank you so much for watching and I'll see you in the next one. Bye.